So today is all about the fear of traveling. What is it that makes you really fear traveling? What's that one thing that makes you really fear? Is it some places that are so weird like this, you know? If you just check here, you'll wonder, is this a road? You can imagine all this is just a road whereby we are supposed to have cars passing all the way this way, but we don't have roads. But people in big cities, they don't know exactly how people live in the villages and the other places. And we fear so much because we think that people are evil, people are bad. And today I want to talk about the fear of traveling, the traveling phobia. What are some of the things that really make people fear traveling? What exactly? What have you heard? For me, one thing I know is the fear of the unknown. You're always told so many things that in the news, in the media, there's always negative stories. We say that negative stories sell more than the way a positive story sells. So if there's something which is weird or something which did not happen so nicely, it will sell like bushfire. That is one thing that I can tell you for sure. People will be saying there is war here, there is war there, people cannot move here. You know, somebody was telling me that, I was asking one of the travelers, a friend of mine, how comes you've been able to travel even in the Middle East, you've traveled in some countries that people really fear so much? And he told me one thing, if there are people living there, definitely it means what? There is life, you can be able to live there. But the media is always telling us, this one is bad, don't try this, you might die, somebody might kill you, and all those kind of things. It's okay. If it happens, it happens. God knows the day that you're going to die. Don't worry about that. So travel more and see the world, because you never know what you might find. Number two, the fear of travel comes because people fear expenses. You think that anytime I'm traveling somewhere, I have to have a lot of money. The other day, another friend of mine was telling me, Keith, there's a time I saw you going to Mombasa and you had a very cool time in Mombasa and you stayed almost a whole month. How did you do it? How on earth did you do it? Because for me, all the time that I go, he was telling me, for me, all the time that I go, I have to stay just 2-3 nights and that's it. Because of what? The expense. Of course, we earn almost similar. I wouldn't say I earn too much, but people have the mentality that when I go to a new place, I have to spend a lot of money. They're always looking for the biggest hotels. You're looking for white sand, sand and sand, and all those. I'm not saying they're bad. If you have the money, fine, go. But if you're a budget traveler and you're a continuous traveler, try as much as you can to live on a budget, to do things in a cheaper way. Always ask yourself, if you go right now to Nairobi or let's say in Mombasa and you're stranded somewhere and it's at night and you're not looking for a place or a hotel where you're going to sleep, what are you going to do? You're going to get a guest house. And some of these guest houses are even much more beautiful than even some of the hotels that you think about. Guest rooms, there are places where you can just go chill out and relax. Because let me tell you, traveling is about the experience. It's not about where you're going to stay, what you're going to do, how you... You know, people just love the photos for Instagram, photos for here, showing all those kind of things. But they forget the little things which make traveling interesting is the people, meeting with the people, going to different places that you've never been, various experiences, testing food from different areas. It's not about where you're sleeping. Sleeping is just any other thing. You can stay in a cheap place, because one of the most expensive things when you're traveling is the accommodation. And that's where the whole story comes in. People value so much on the accommodation, where they're going to sleep, more than the experience. And that's where you go wrong. So you have to find a way that accommodation, yes, is good. You have to stay in a good place, but don't put it so much heavy of a budget, like 80% of your budget is there. The other thing I'll talk about why people fear traveling is because you always have stories every day of some bad things which happened to someone when he was on travel. I don't know how I explain this story very well, because all the time their stories about something which happened. He went here and this happened and this person got lost and this person did that. If you put your safety measures in place, safety measures like what? When you're traveling, always know who are you interacting with? Who are you meeting up with? Because if you don't also make good friends when you're traveling, it might be a bit tricky for you, because making friends is an easy thing, but still, if you're an introvert, it may be a little bit problematic for you. Let's take for example, when I travel to different places, I make a lot of friends. I make a lot of friends from website like Couchsurfing, whereby I can stay with some few locals or hang out and just have a good time together. Or sometimes I can pick an Airbnb. Airbnb, there's an owner of the house, there's a host. He or she can be able to tell me what to do, where to visit. We can hang out, we can play some cards, we can have some drinks, we can have some food. You know, they can tell me about the area and all those kind of things. So it becomes much more easy for me to make friends, because they also have friends, they are local. They can tell me this place is bad, this place is good to visit, this and this and this. Just make friends. There are so many apps that you can use. There's another one called Travel Buddy. Travel Buddy, whenever you want to travel and you don't have a friend, when you go on Travel Buddy app, you will find other people who also want to travel to a similar location like yours, and you can gang up and become friends. And as well, when I'm traveling as well, I go to hostels. There are hostels. Just go and check Hostel World. Hostel World is an application whereby you can be able to go and hang out to different places in hostels, have some good parties, enjoy, chill out, and all those kind of things. Because they're also travelers like you. They stay in one place, like a dorm, stuff like that. So it's much more very, very nice, especially if you travel places where there are many people and you can have some bonfires and all those kind of things. So, and maybe as I wind up this video, because I just wanted it to be a short video, just a recap of traveling things. When you're traveling, there are other things that you also need to put in mind. Put in mind how your itinerary is going to be. The first time I went to Tanzania, it was very funny because I went there, I just stayed in my hotel room, I just went round here and there, two, three places, and I didn't know where to see. Only exactly what I had in mind about Tanzania is what I went to see. I did not take time to Google and check what are some of the fancy things and places that I can be able to travel. I thought I knew it all, so I just told the taxi guy, take me here, but I did not Google about the same. So if you Google things to do in Tanzania, things to do in Dar es Salaam, things to do in Nairobi, things to do whichever place you're in. Right now I'm in Bomet. Bomet County, there's so much to see. But I will not know it because I'm not a local. So all I need to do is Google a little bit, things to do in Bomet, and then you will see various things that you can be able to do, things that you can be able to enjoy and all that. And this one will help you so much not to waste your time sitting down in one place and thinking that that is the end of the whole trip and I don't have any other thing that I can be able to do and there are no places to see. Google is your friend. Just like they say, police is your friend. I don't know if it's true, but Google is your friend. Just make Google your friend if you're a traveler. So I hope these points have really encouraged you and made you at least have a positive thought about traveling, and of course overcome the fear of traveling, because the fear of traveling is what makes people not come out from their comfort zone. Because when you go out there, you're going to find other people, you're going to learn different cultures, you're going to learn how people do their things, how people enjoy, how people other different tricks of things. Sometimes you can even go to a place and find things which are being sold cheaply, and in your place they are very expensive. You buy and you go and sell here. So there are opportunities of traveling. Traveling, it's a whole wide experience of things. So hope this one has really impacted something in your brain. Kindly, if you're not subscribed, just subscribe down there. There's a subscription button. Hit that notification button so that you don't miss any video like this. If you're watching from Facebook, on Instagram, or whichever other place, kindly just like, comment, share this video so that it can teach someone else something, a thing or a two. God bless you. Have a blessed time. See ya.